Owners of the Mountain T-shirt company admit they owe some of their success to the power of the internet.
But don't forget the shirts, manufactured with painstaking care and unique designs.
Welcome to the mountain. No snow-capped peaks here. This mountain is a t-shirt company located at the Fisk Mill in Marlboro.
We call it artwear.
Jeff Grosner, now a company director, was the first employee. Just the man to tell us how the mountain grew from a crew of six in 1993, selling to
little hippie stores that sold incense and Guatemalan imports,
to now about 150 employees cranking out some 10,000 t-shirts a day.
We're pretty much a global brand at this point, and we're really happy about that.
Archival t-shirts tell the story.
This is a piece from the early 90s of Grateful Dead. It's actually hand-printed, Bob Marley. We're bringing in some photorealism. The Gina Gray period, where we're actually partnering with an artist, bringing together all the attributes of the Mountain t-shirt, which is the model die, and then the really big graphic. Then we went into early 2000s. This is a patriotic design. Next thing that happened was a landmark t-shirt, Three Wolf Moon, and that was just a viral t-shirt that just exploded on the internet.
Their internet luck all began with a Rutgers University graduate student who stumbled on the Three Wolf Moon t-shirt online.
And he just wrote this really funny review, not very flattering, but just really super funny. The review essentially said that the t-shirt was imbued with magical powers, some very good outcomes with members of the opposite sex. It's really opened doors for us and really allowed us to expand as a company, so that was definitely a landmark shirt.
The Big Face Pug Dog shirt followed, one of their biggest sellers. Of course, we had to see how these t-shirts are made.
We start with a blank white t-shirt. We have a proprietary model dye process. So it kind of looks like a tie-dye, but it also looks like a hand-dyed t-shirt, which it is.
After the shirts are dyed, they're dried and prepped for printing. Meanwhile, the artwork is color separated. A different stencil screen is created for each color.
Each image that gets printed will have anywhere from 4 to 8 screens.
These precision machines move the shirts from one stencil screen to the next, where ink is spread one color at a time. With the artwork complete, the shirts are placed on the dryer. On the other end, shirts pop out, ready for packaging.
This is before and after, so this is a wet print, what I'm holding here. To your right is the dried or cured print. You can see all the colors popping, particularly the white areas here.
Now, there's another artistic enterprise in Marlboro.
Turn a little faster. There you go.
And this one is for you to learn and try yourself.
My name is Jordana Corson, and I'm a glassblower. I'm an educator. This place is the Hot Glass Art Center. It's a facility for the public to come in and see glass blowing, try glass blowing, or see what kind of work is made locally. We offer lessons to people that know what they're doing, to people who've never touched hot glass before. You can come in off the street and say, I'm interested in learning how to blow glass.
Jim Hassinger did just that. He dropped in for a lesson.
Totally out of the blue. I had just retired, a friend recommended it. No arts background, I had a business career, took a class, that was it. Totally hooked.
Turning nice and slow, using some gravity. The skill is how to control the glass. The glass is a liquid, it's moving all the time. And in order to shape it, manipulate it, and turn it into an object that we would call a blown glass object, you have to constantly reheat and shape. That little lift is all you needed.
Lessons are $100 an hour, but
price includes all materials and fees, and the work is ready the next day, so it's pretty immediate gratification. It's so close to being awesome.
That is so cool to me. And anyone can go in and watch, right?
Yeah, no charge to go in and watch and see how things are done. If you want to take a class, obviously you have to pay for that. Back to the Mountain T-shirt company, too. They try to be a very green company. They showed us some pretty impressive technology as to how they pull pollutants out of their wastewater before it goes back out into the world. So good and green.
Incredible. The rules are different on Stonewall Farm.
You got to have a barn dog named Rooster.